What would you do without collections? Nearly every Java application makes and processes collections. They are fundamental to many programming tasks. They let you group and process data. On the sample from Oracle, first we obtain a string from the list of transactions, the data, using the string method available list. Next, with several operations, filter, sort, and map, collect, are chained together to form a pipeline, which can be seen as forming a query on the data. Java 8 brings new amazing functionalities, some of them based on Lambda expressions. These three new functionalities apply on the collections interface and is the base of this video. A collection can be filtered by several forms. For example, we suppose we have a class student. We create a list of students. Suppose that we need filter all students with name starts with J and printed. The traditional approach and the verbose way is to infer a for iterate over all of them and apply an if-then-else structure. The new string approach creates a lambda expression. Using the function string, you create a string object based on the collection. If it's generically defined, it's easier to infer the inner attributes inside the objects of the list. The filter method can apply any desired Boolean operation for the items on the list. We can, for example, modify the sample for filter only the ones with age less than 30. Now let's put some more intelligence inside and sort the list in the ages, ordering the list to younger to older. We must implement the interface comparable in the student class. And after, create a string using the function sorted. It returns a sort of students by age and filter all of those younger than 30. Barry 18, Elton 20, Scott 23. We can provide an update on the sample using our previous knowledge about Java 8 Lambda expressions exposed on the previous video. We can just not implement the interface comparable, for the implementation and maintain the class as before. After that, we provide our own comparable expression value for this stream. Now it will return the sort of students ordered by name exactly as we did before. The strings allow us to create new collections based on it. For example, if we need a new list based on that sorted list, we can try something like this. The collectors allow us to group items or taking the average of items, including some interest features very similar to SQL functions. The string feature comes in good time, exceptionally interesting for people developing systems for XML parsing or flat files. Those features can be very handy and time-saving. Check the reference on the blog of Benjamin Winterberg for further samples and the original document for string interface.